Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you on how to access your modem's GUI or the graphical user interface when your modem is in bridge mode. Let's do it. If you haven't watched my video tutorial about configuring the TP-Link into a bridge mode, I put the link in the description down below. Please watch it. Without any further ado, let's get started. So this is our current setup in our network. This is the modem and our network is on 192.168.1.0/24 and the modem IP address is 192.168.1.1 and it is directly connected to our router. I am using Mikrotik router and the IP address of the router that is directly connected to the modem is 192.168.1.2. When the modem is on bridge mode, the DHCP is still enabled on this one. So when I plug in this connection between the modem and the router, my router should be able to get an IP address from the pool. But in my case, I statically assigned an IP address to my router, which is this one here, the 1.2. And my router, my inside network is 192.168.88.0/24. And I have my computers connected to the other port and it's on the 88.0 network. Now for time being, I won't be able to access the GUI or the graphical user interface of the modem because these two networks doesn't know each other yet. Our router doesn't know about this network yet, the 1.0/24, and the modem as well doesn't know this network. So this is where we need to configure so that they will know each other. Now let's jump into my computer and go to the command prompt and let's have a look our network IP address. IP config just to verify. So at the moment our IP address is 192.168.60, so we are in the network 88.0/24, right? If I were going to ping the IP address of the modem, it is expected that I will get a request timeout. Let's do that. And yeah, that's confirmed. We get a request timeout. Let's close this one and let's open our Mikrotik router. If you are using Mikrotik router as well, so this is where you go. But if you're using a different router, the logic is still the same. It's just a matter of adding a routes. I use a Winbox to access my Mikrotik router. First thing I need to check is I'm going to the IP and addresses. As you can see in here, I'm gonna hide my public IP here. I created statically an IP address on my Ether 1 or the port number 1 of my router. And I assign it with 192.168.1.2 on /24. Let's open our IP routes. This is our IP route list. I am using Mikrotik though, so I'm not sure if this is the case with other router. If you look at this one here, if I'm going to disable this IP address that I statically assigned, the route is also gone. But if I'm going to enable it, that will be created automatically. So in our router side, basically we don't need to do anything. We don't need to add route anymore because it's created automatically. But just in case your router doesn't do that, you can manually add a route and the destination address should be the modem's network. So in our case, it is 192.168.1.0/24. That's our modem's network address. And the gateway, that will be the address of the other end, which is 192.168.1.1. This is IP address of the modem. Also, if you know the interface, you can use the interface as well, which is in our case, it is directly connected to the Ether one. You can use that as well, but you can use also the IP address of the other end. So click apply, and that should be able to tell you that it's reachable through the Ether one gateway, which is the interface. But in our case here, we don't need this one because it is dynamically created already. So I'm going to delete that one. So that's in your router side. Basically, you don't need to do anything. Now let's jump into the modem side and let's configure from there. By the way, because the modem and the router is directly connected, we should be able to ping the modem from here. We're going to open my terminal and type the ping 192.168.1.1. As you can see, I am able to ping the modem from the router. And yeah, like I said, that's because they are directly connected with each other. Now let's jump into the modem configuration. Okay, so I plugged my computer now in the modem. Let's verify that. IP config. And as you can see, I have now IP address of 192.168.1. that 101. It's not that 88 anymore. So if I will ping 192.168.88.1 network or the router, I should be able to get request timeout because the modem doesn't know that network yet. Although the router already added it dynamically to the route list, but the modem hasn't done anything yet on the modem side's configuration. And I'm going to continually ping the router so that we can see the changes straight away once we do the configuration from the modem. Now let's jump into our modem. So 192.168.1.1 and your password. Now in our modem, all we need to do is to add a route. Go to advanced, go to network, and look at the static routing. And from there, you can add a route, click add. And from here, the network destination would be the 192.168.88.0, which is the other side, the inside network of the router. And the subnet mask, because that is /24, so that would be 255.255.0. And the gateway. So what will be the gateway? The gateway would be the IP address that you assigned on the router side, which is 192.168.1.2. That's the one that we assign that is directly connected to the modem. So that will be your gateway. On the router side, it was 1.1 because that's the other end IP address of the modem that is directly connected to the router. And the interface would be LAN. Before I press OK on the one, let's open this one. See, you can see that should be able to reply. There you go. After we add the route, we are able to ping the 88.1. This modem now knows this network. Let's close this one. Now with the TP-Link modem router, after the configuration of the static routing, here's one thing that you need to change as well. When you're accessing the modem router in a different network, it becomes now a remote access. So in that case, in TP-Link side, we need to enable the remote access that is in the system tools in the administration. And in here, remote management, you have to enable this one, remote management. Otherwise, you still not be able to access the modem, although you can ping it. But you cannot access the graphical user interface. And like I said, you are accessing it in a different network. So it's treated as a remote. So click save on that one. And that's it. Now let's go back to our network, the 88.1. And let's try access this GUI from there. Now we're back to the 88.0 network. Let's verify that. IP config. Oops. And as you can see, my IP address is now back to the 88.60. But in this case, if I were going to ping 192.168.1.1, I should get a reply. Our network now knows the 192.168.1.1 network. Now let's try to browse the modem. And by the way, make sure to not forget about the port number on the remote management. Otherwise, you cannot access it because you need to use this port. I'm just gonna copy that. If you open that using just 192.168.1.1, it's forbidden because you are accessing it remotely. You need to put in the port number, which is the 62379. And there you go. Proceed. And your password. Voila! You have now access to your modem from your inside network while your modem is on bridge mode. And that's about it, guys. Please help me by subscribing to this channel. Thank you very much for watching.